Hello, everyone, and welcome to episode 21 of Enterprise Technology India Unplugged. This is a very special episode because we have a great entrepreneur with us. And as usual, we also have Kumaran, who is the chief technical officer and the chief mentor for Tiny Magic. And we have with us Latashree, who is actually going to introduce herself now. Go ahead, Latashree.
So I'm an entrepreneur where I'm planning an app with a fashion background in it. So I want my app is more on, it's a concept of online boutique, which I'm very interested to introduce in the market. I don't know how the response would be for the boutique because I come from an engineering background. So more than fashion, the technology part interests me a lot. So I was, my concept of fashion and technology clubbing together was an idea to introduce the app in the market.
Let me ask you a simple question before we get into the technology. How did this idea come to you?
I used to run a physical boutique in Hyderabad. So while doing it, the online retail market was starting with clothing and all. So, but then there were always the ready-made stuff which were available. I wanted it to work with the designers and get your design to be designed by a designer and your garment to be made by a designer. So that's when I thought that this kind of boutique idea online would be a new concept to be introduced in.
Kumaran, you had a question. Yes, go ahead.
Yeah, so basically I was, what stage are you in making this happen? See, I think the classical thing which we have an idea, right? And we know that the technology will solve the problem, but we don't know the specifics of which technology will solve. We have so many technology and which technology and how it will solve. Mm-hmm. And also, how much of money do I need to put in? Because technology is such a black hole. You can spend 100 rupees or you could spend 100 million also, and still you don't know whether you will have the solution, correct? What stage of this journey are you in?
Yeah, I'm in a very early stage where I'm planning the app itself, the physical aspect, like the color of the app and how to design the app, it's more of a manual kind of an app wherein not much of technology is being used. Because I don't know how the response would be with the app, how I'll get the customers to like the app or the business to happen on the app. So right now, I am not investing much in it. Slowly, I want to upgrade it, slowly getting the technology part, wherein what AI and all have done for Netflix, wherein you go onto Netflix and it gives you some matching your profile. It shows you some movies that this might interest you, or either the percentage of matching with your interest shows on the thing. So these are all later which I want to get into the app. Right now it's a basic app where you just get in. There are 50 designers in it. You have to personally go and see the designer's work and pick the designer. But might be later if the things go properly, when a new customer comes onto the app and he gives his logistics into the app itself can navigate you through the different designers and get you onto the right person whom you're looking at, and the work can go ahead like that. I mean, those are my plans. I don't know how.
No, that's good. That's actually good, and I think you have an advantage. A technologist usually go too much into technology first.
Yeah.
Now, actually, I think you're taking a much practical and prudent approach here. So currently you have one version of the app which is already ready, or what?
It's on the vendor section, which we have uploaded on the Play Store.
Okay.
Yeah, when I approach a vendor, I need to show him that this is the kind of work it is we have been doing, and this is how it is. I have to show the presentation. So the vendor side of the app has been uploaded, where I've appointed people who are making calls to the designers and approaching them to join our platform. So, okay. Yeah. So after I have an N number of designers who are working with us, even on the app, I have a fashion consultant facility available wherein the person can even consult the stylist and go ahead with his opinion about the garment and idea about the, if it's an occasion, the stylist can guide you what kind of clothes might look, and that kind of facilities also I'm planning on the app. So that's on a very basic thing. Once I have N number of designers and consultants and everybody, that's when I'm going to upload the customer application onto the Play Store. And then the full, yeah.
So you have a development team or a person working. Is it like you have got them work part-time for you, or is it like they work full-time? How is it?
I have gone to a company to get my app designed with.
Okay. So I think one of the ideas which, as an architect, which I have already suggested, right, it's about putting the customer at the center of the action, okay, which I think is, so in fact, the initial part, right, if it's about, even if you get just one customer, right, who can come through and select their options, right? So actually, let's look at it this way. If you had a customer-facing portal where they could select their requirements, right? Now you go to a vendor and say, you know, I have an order, will you do it? There's no way he's going to refuse.
Yeah, definitely.
The person is not going to refuse. So it's actually, if you take the other way, where you have a interested customer, asking a designer to agree will become a lot more easier thing to convince them than you join at some point, we will get in. And I think from talking to you so far, you have enough experience in that area to at least you have at least 4 or 5 designers who you can actually call up with your goodwill and then say, look, don't ask me money, don't ask me margin, I've got this, just do this 2-3 things for me. Yeah. I'm sure you have that kind of a thing.
Yeah.
So getting a paid customer validated will be a lot more easier for you to move stuff and build much more confidence. See, there is not, and I think as a person who's run business, right, even if you get 1,000 rupees from a customer, that will give you much more confidence than having 100 designers and still you haven't made one sale.
But then to get the confidence of the customer, I have to have a N number of designers so that the customers get confident that the work can be done in a proper way.
I think, okay, that's true. But there are ways in which you can play with technology to do that. You need not kind of expose them to how many designers you are having. It's not really necessary for the customer to know how many. You just have what the intention that you want to show them is they have choice.
Yeah.
One designer giving 100 designs, right, or 50 designers giving one design, you would actually prefer one designer giving 100 designs. So what the customer needs is the choice.
Yeah.
So if you can present the choice to them, the number of designers really become irrelevant.
Yeah. No, actually, the garment are of different categories. Like few designers are expertized in, like, say, ghagras and the wedding section of it. few days guys are more into casual wear of it. And I also want to promote the sustainable fashion in my platform, because that's the most, that's one of the thing which has to be come into prominence now, because if I just stick to sustainable fashion and have just sustainable designers, I think only just a small amount of people are more knowledgeable about this concept. So that's when I thought I should have both the platforms wherein I have sustainable designers as well as the normal designers. So when a customer comes onto the app, he's able to see both the platforms and then decide and get, at the same time, the awareness will also, I want to promote the awareness also. So when he comes onto the platform, he can see both the both kind of garments to be displayed on it and then take a decision and slowly transform, even as you said, even one customer transforming into sustainable fashion would be a kind of achievement, like for me.
I think that what you're facing is a classical challenge when we go and try to solve a problem. Okay, so it's basically, especially when you're solution, right? Can cater to a range of audience. Okay. Now the challenge is when you are trying to, if let's say you want to address all types of audience. Okay, different audiences. Yes, you have a large audience base. Okay, but your messaging and your features, all that also becomes very hard. Okay, so I think I have you seen this chain called I think it's called some Vada Pav shots or something. There is one chain.
Okay.
They sell only Vada Pav, nothing else. Okay. They do only Vada Pav, and probably they sell a cool drink along with it. That's it. It's a small shop. And they sell only Vada Pav, okay. And then there was also these things in Chennai especially, right? So there is these people who came up with just selling coffee, only filter coffee.
Okay.
So they sold, so when they began, they sold only filter coffees, nothing else, right? After a couple of years, they started selling snacks along with that. Now that is called a zoom in model of business. In Tiny Magic, we kind of recommend that for people who are starting stuff. You zoom in first and then you zoom out. Now the advantages of zooming in, like let's take both Vada Pav and coffee, right? As a person who's starting the business, it is very easy for me to get certain investments in place. So to make a coffee, I know the problems that I have to deal with. I need to get a good coffee powder, milk, and that's all I have to focus on. Okay. But if I kind of say, oh, that means I'm restricting myself only to a coffee, somebody would like to have a dosa or a puri like that, then I need to get a chef. It becomes, makes the problem harder for me. Yeah. Okay. But there is a bunch of customers who will walk in who just want to have coffee and go. In fact, it's interesting. They realize that there are people who just want to have a good coffee at 3 in the afternoon. That's it. Come 5 minutes, have a good coffee and go. In fact, they wouldn't walk into a Saravana Bhavan or a Shanti Sagar kind of a place, I think, or like a chutney kind of place, right, in Hyderabad. To have a coffee, I don't want to go till chutney. But if I can get that quality of coffee here, I will actually have 4 coffees in a day. So when we start off, if you focusing into that helps us identify those. So it's actually easier for me to get the first customer. And even when I started my own company, the first company which I stand and failed was trying to offer all sorts of services. That became a big problem. So here, changing mindset and behavior, we tried and we said we will do for lot of any possible area, whether it is HR or sales and things like that. It became very hard. Then we started focusing, we will focus only on helping digital transformation to happen. It became a lot easier for us. And we also got a very good specific identity. Now, once you kind of establish yourself and you get your first, let's say, 100 customers, then those customers itself will become the pathway for you to expand.
Yeah, they'll be guiding us what they require.
They will guide. And the beauty of that is you can use their money to expand your business. You don't have to put in your money.
Yeah.
Okay. So that's something you could consider, you know, can I zoom in into one part where it is much easier? For example, let's say you want to do sustainable. So today, let's say you have to do marketing or advertising to get a customer, correct? You said you have been doing Instagram. And what are the places that you would go? Can you give some example? Like, you want to address all customers. In Facebook, let's say you have to do, where would you go and push your marketing content or your ads?
See, actually, I had the Facebook gives one message that if you want to promote, they'll you have to pay a certain amount and the promotion will be done.
Correct.
So I had taken few of those facilities too. But then the kind of data which they were giving to me, that was not relevant to the pages what I was maintaining. So those were not my customers who I was getting like when I buy the data. So I thought even if one like or two like which are coming by itself is more important than getting 100 likes, because the hundreds are not relevant to the topics what I'm discussing on. So.
Perfect.
Yeah.
So now let's just apply what I just said, right? Just try that, right? Like, let's say you're just going to focus on sustainable design. If you had to do that, then the audience that you have to go through becomes a little more easier. Like, there are many sustainable communities and Facebook groups which is there. You can go to that place and then say, you know, I have a new cloth line. I just designed this. You just share it. It's not even marketing. You just say, you know, I've been able to design something for myself, right? You don't even tell that you're marketing. You just say, one of my customers wanted this. I did this. There's actually no customer, but you can go to that group and put it there. So there are eco-friendly groups, nature-friendly groups, sustainable groups, vegan groups like that. So you become these groups and then you say, one of my customers wanted this, I did this. What do you guys think about it? That is a very subtle way of marketing and using technology. But it becomes a lot more easier when you think sustainable. But in the other case, the amount of Facebook groups you have to identify becomes very large. And it's hard to deal with as a startup entrepreneur. You have so many battles to fight, right?
So I have a question on the specific technology area, because since we discussed quite a bit about how you can get started, and Kumar gave you really good advice. I think you should look at that. So from technology perspective, and especially when you mentioned artificial intelligence, what do you expect to happen? So let's say you choose this sustainable design and sustainable apparel and you go after that market. What is it that you expect technology to help you do? I understand you don't have all the answers, but what is your expectation from the technology to help you do?
Yeah, that's what I said. Mine is a basic manual app where you have to come in, you have to search for the designers, go to their profile, and just go on clicking until you're satisfied with the particular designer. Then you have to give your own manually you have to fill the measurement chart which the designer would be giving to you. So if all these things which are being done manually can also be done technically, like like I had discussed, like the AI technology, if it comes into the app, wherein when you go and give just the profile, if you fill your profile and the app itself guides you to a, like I have N number of designers, but then because of your profile, just the 10 designers are matching to your requirements. That would be an easier way for the...
So something like a recommendation engine, which you mentioned initially, is that you want something like Netflix. So it knows what you like.
Yeah, it matches your profile. It advises you whom to pick and which would be a better option for you. So that kind of facility would be a very... if you see this, if you fill in your photograph and your measurements, and you can see the garment on your phone, because the smartphone has become so easy to navigate now. So if this kind of facilities are given to the customers, because the main issue is now the time management is a big issue, and then exchange of clothing is a big issue. So all these factors, and contactless shopping is a big issue. So all these factors would be addressed with this technology if we inculcate it to the app. Yeah, that's how I want the technology to be used for the app.
So I think that there are have you narrowed down on some of the technologies which you want to use, or do you have reference designs which you are going to use, or you are still looking for the technology to be decided?
Yeah, I'm still exploring, because these are ideas which I have, but I don't know where to approach and how to go about. So right now I'm planning a basic app wherein you have to manually do it and see how the response is there in the market. After that might be slowly upgradation of the app with introducing this technology would be what I'm planning to go about.
Okay. So one of the things, right, usually... when we are starting up and we don't want to put in too much money into things, right? So one thing is basically try to use a existing service, which is called what we typically called as SaaS, software as a service, instead of you building your own app ground up. Okay, buy an existing service and try to use that. Like as you are talking, right, it's new for me, so I was just looking at something like were there things like that. So there are existing applications which will you can be like a subscriber there. You upload your content and that place will help you fit things into that. Like for example, if you take Amazon, it's a marketplace. Amazon sells stuff, it helps other sellers also sell, correct?
Yeah.
So similarly, in your domain, you look for a place where this kind of feature, it need not be, even if it's a 30% match, right? You can actually use that, where adding vendors and other things becomes a lot more easier. A marketplace for designers or making custom clothes. So you avail that service, since you can focus on what is core to you.
Yeah.
And once with this, you kind of validate it, right? You are able to get the requirements from the... And also there is another cheat I will treat you, okay? It's a cheating technique, okay? It's called monkey in a box, okay? This is a very well-kept secret in the technology industry. I'm going to teach that to you, okay? Only very specialist architects use this technology. Ordinary architects cannot do this, but because you are a great architect, I'm going to teach this to you, okay? What that means is, like, let's say there is a complex set of tasks to be done, okay? So in your case, it's something like take the requirements from the user, okay? And just ask them a few questions about their basic likes, dislikes, okay? And then find the right designer for it, okay, and probably also suggest a few sample kind of designs to say, look at these designs. If you like this design, I will give you that designer. If you like that design, I will give you that designer. Okay. Now, if you can have an app which can do this to you on day one, you will be extremely happy, right?
Yeah, definitely.
Okay. So, in order to implement this with very minimal money, you actually do this. Okay. So, you do first, you just do a simple screen which will capture these four basic questions, which can be done very easily to the customer. Okay. Now, what we do is, like, let's say that in olden days, right, we needed to have optical character recognition, which means you submit a written document, text has to be converted and keywords extracted out of that and put it into a system so that it can be searched. But the doctors will write it in scribbling handwriting. So do you know what the solution was for that? It's called transcribing. It was very popular some 25 years ago. Okay. Basically, they will scan the image, send it to India. Some three guys will be sitting here, look at that thing and actually type it in, looking at that scanned image.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
And as they're typing in, they'll be trained for what the keyword is, and then they will make it into a format which is searchable. Okay. So the secret is, for the end customer, he just writes a written copy into that box, which has a small hole. But there's a monkey sitting inside there taking that paper and actually doing the manual work. There's no technology inside it.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah.
He types out the electronic forms and gives it out. But for the end user, the experience is automatic.
Okay. Yeah.
Okay. So what you could do is think of a monkey in a box approach, where you take these questions, but it is you who will look at their questions, look at their preferences selected, and select the designer and just connect the direct designer to them. Today, you will do this manually for every single customer.
That's where I have put a fashion consultant there, so that even if the person wants to go about, he just have to consult the fashion consultant. He'll design. He'll give you a concept about designing. He'll advise things. And at the same time, he will also help you to pick the designers from the app, so that what you say, he'll be manually doing it. But for the customer, it will look like it's being done technically.
So I'm curious, what stops you from doing that tomorrow?
I didn't get it.
Is that service available to the customer today, to your customers?
It's there in the app. I have even have an icon where a fashion consultant is there. You can directly, when you get into the app, you can directly go to the fashion consultant and then check with the designers, or you can yourself navigate through the app and pick your designer.
Oh, okay. So I think I kind of missed the point. So this app is available for customers also today?
Not yet. It's not in the market. We are still in the, getting the vendors on the app.
So that's the curious thing. I was just asking, why, what stops you from getting to the customer tomorrow? Why not give it to the company if this feature is already there?
People on the platform. No, I haven't got the designer.
You mean the designers?
Yeah, designers. And so I'm going through the, there's so many people there, so I have to chalk down the number of designers and who.
Okay. So do you have at least 5-10 designers now? Or you still have to?
We still have to get it because there are some problems which came on the app. So these things are being rectified. Once they're done, and then we'll start making the calls.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
So I think, okay, got it. Deepak, you have.
So I think we had a very good discussion, and I think Lata has a lot of work to do still, and we wish her luck to do that. And of course, Kumaran has given great advice around what is actually possible for you to achieve. And so what would we would like to do is also to invite you back when you actually have the application ready, and we can talk about it in more detail and probably even do a demo of your application and try and see from technology perspective and from the architecture perspective how you have progressed. And I think that is a really good start. What do you think, Kumaran?
I guess so, but just wanted to just check, right? I think we have been telling something and asking some questions. Do you have any still lingering questions that you want to ask us?
Yeah, now that I came to know about the architectural part which you people are doing, so the kind of suggestions and the things you have told me, that's really helpful. I'll try to implement them. And then, as you said, once I'm completed with my work, I'll again come and showcase it to you people and then take your advice. So,
yeah, we could also do another thing, right? Like when you feel that you have reached, it can be anything, a milestone. A milestone can be a milestone of achievement, or it could be a milestone of roadblock also. It doesn't matter, right? So we could again do a session, and probably over a period of time, your series will become a separate series itself, where you'll say, you know, this is how the story of a startup happened. And we can say, you know, look at this 3 months back, 6 months, like that. So either way, we'll be glad to connect again and talk. It is, it's good. Nice, great idea, and wishing you luck.
So thank you, Lafa, and thank you to our listeners and viewers to keep subscribing to our channel. So we'll be available always. Like Lafa, if you have a great idea which you want to discuss with us, we'll be happy to listen to your ideas. Especially you are talking about technology and architecture and how these things tie together. Kumaran and I are always interested in listening to new ideas and even giving you sometimes our free advice, which you can take it or leave it, right? So take it with a pinch of salt. We share our experiences with you, and we will listen to your feedback. And thank you, everyone, and see you next time.